The official answer to the question, is argon gas necessary for permanent jewelry welding? I get asked this several times a day, and no matter what I say, I know I am going to upset a large group of people because it is so controversial. So let's jump right in. Today in this video, I am going to talk about my thoughts on this topic and my experience. Then I'm going to share with you some comparison welds, as well as the official word from Sunstone Engineering, the makers of the leading permanent jewelry welders, the Orion series of welders. So I hope you enjoy this. A bit over a year ago, I posted a video on whether or not argon gas is necessary for micro welding and permanent jewelry. And in that video, I demonstrated how to hook up the regulator to the argon gas tank and then to the welder, welding some demonstrations with and without argon gas, as well as going out, I filmed myself going out and getting refill of the gas. I'm going to leave a card, a link to the video, so you might find that informative. Since then, I've done more research, and today I want to amend some of my words. The definitive answer is, it is not absolutely necessary to use argon gas when welding permanent jewelry in order to achieve a secure weld. It has its benefits, but it's not absolutely necessary. For industrial welding, such as for construction of I-beams, car frames, bicycle frames, etc., the bigger things, argon gas is absolutely necessary in order to achieve a secure weld. There's no way of getting around it. I have test weld different thicknesses of jump rings and different metals. And aside from less oxidation when I'm using argon gas, and actually it does not completely eliminate oxidation, it does reduce it. Aside from that, I noticed that I can, with argon gas, have slightly lower power setting and achieve the same strength of weld as without argon gas. So in other words, if I don't have argon gas, I would just need to increase the power setting slightly in order to achieve the same strength of weld if I'm doing permanent jewelry. There is no worry about security of the weld. You should always check security anyway, but for permanent jewelry, there is no worry. And you would have to clean the oxidation with a fiberglass brush. Now, I do notice that when I am welding things that are thicker, such as stud post onto earring backs, castings, or thicker bangles, the benefits of argon gas are a lot more pronounced and there's less dipping and I can use slightly lower temperature. So when it's thicker, you do notice a bigger difference, but for permanent jewelry and jump rings for that, it's not necessary. So now I'm going to read the official word from Sunstone Engineering, and the exact words, this letter, will be published on my website, and I'm going to link to it below. Argon gas is way more controversial than it needs to be. The benefits of argon when used for permanent jewelry are less noticeable than with other forms of welding because of the size of the weld is so small. In larger scale welding, the welding system would not work and damage would occur if gas was not used. Simply put, in normal welding outside of jewelry, there is no application where gas is not required. It is universally used and required. The main benefits of argon are: pushes oxygen away from the weld site, preventing unwanted oxides to form in the molten metal. Protects and prolongs the electrode tip. Electrode will remain sharper and last longer. Less porosity holes. In your finished welds, oxygen and oxides cannot get trapped in the metal. Pulse arc welding uses a plasma arc. This plasma is what generates the amount of heat needed to melt the metal. The ions in the gas are positively charged and help create a stable arc. More consistency in creating welds, as the arc will be stabilized by argon gas. More consistency of welds, less misfires. Argon will help the metal flow together better. Less oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen contaminated the weld flow. And the letter continues. The key is the use of a noble gas. There are 7 total. All but 2 are far too expensive for welding use. Argon and helium are the 2 options that can be used for a shielding gas. Argon is used on all metals and all applications. It is ideal for every welding condition. Helium is more expensive in most cases, less effective in some alloys. That is why argon is our most recommended. We have used helium is our systems and had great luck. There you have it, it's official. Argon gas is not absolutely necessary for permanent jewelry welding. It certainly has its benefits, and you must weigh the benefits with the cost and convenience factor. So, I really hope you've enjoyed this, and if you have, please like and subscribe. Let me know what you think of it and whether or not you are currently using argon gas in your welding.